Hello, everyone.
Welcome to the Smoothie King Center in New Orleans, Louisiana, as we get set for the first game of the season between the New Orleans Pelicans and the Orlando Magic. First game of the season. Coach going to make some changes and switch up the matchups. Holiday against Oladipo. Anderson looking to dupe the defense, draws the double team. There's a foul. It's called against the Magic. Now they're over the limit and the penalty, so free throws for the Pelicans.
Great effort by the defender trying to slide over and take the big-time charge. Instead, hit with a blocking foul because he was just a count late.
Good touch inside.
Hey, sometimes good offense beats good defense. There's nothing to be ashamed with on that possession. That was a well-defended, well-contested shot.
Double team closing in, unable to bring it home. Lets it go, puts it in. That's a two-pointer. Four-point lead for New Orleans.
The double team, the intensity of the double team had an impact on that offensive possession, forcing the turnaround jump shot.
Backing his man down. Holiday jump shot. Curls in. Nice adjustment. No question. Yep, that's a foul called against the Pelicans. Their first team foul. And he'll head to the line with just seconds to go in the second. And he hits the first free throw. Goes two for two at the line. Water winding down, he just flips it up. So, end of the first half, and we're all tied up. Welcome back to the Smoothie King Center for the second half. Jeff Van Gundy alongside me here tonight. Mike Breen on hand. Orlando's had some sweet shooting in that first half, Jeff, but it might be a bad omen. They're still tied.
Mike, I couldn't agree with you more. Just because it's tied and just because you see some good offensive numbers doesn't mean it's headed in the right direction. When you shoot well and you're only tied in half, that means your other parts of your game has gaping holes in it. And right now, that's true.
This is from downtown.
Hey, that's good offense right there. All you can do is create open shots. That's an open shot. Chance to give him the lead. Missed it. But keep creating those type of good looks.
Five left on the 24. Hits the shot. With the jumper for three.
Ryan Anderson! That's what I'm talking about. Three!
Oladipo from downtown. Unable to convert the three. Nate Walters with the ball. To the basket. Plumlee the rebound. Tries to the alley-oop. Here's an interception. For two again here. Can't knock it down.
Hey, they give you 24 seconds for a reason. It's not 7 seconds or less like the old Phoenix Suns.
Fires with two on the 24.
Sometimes the simplest plays are the hardest ones to execute. Good layup.
Lots of room there. Won't go from three-point range. Ryan Anderson's 1-for-2 from long range. He curls. On lay for two. Can't convert on his first shot of the night.
Some might question that shot right there. I like that shot. You have a great player who's a great shooter. I like the creativity. He just missed it.
Fires away from downtown. Knocks down the three-pointer. It'll count if it goes. And that will end the third quarter. Orlando up by 4. Stay with us for more NBA on... This has a chance to be a beauty right now. No one able to pull ahead.
This is a classic game so far. Well played on both sides. I'm going to feel badly for whichever team doesn't win this ball game because they played quality basketball.
The Magic with the ball in control. Curling in with the rim. No doubt about it. He hit him. It's called against Walters. Picks up his first personal. It's on to the line for a couple of free throws. Knocks down the first one. No back-to-back free throws here. He misses the second. Ball knocked loose. Out of bounds.
Thinks every missed shot is a pass to himself and going after every rebound.
Drew Holiday with the ball in possession. Pokes it up. Oh, nice touch inside.
2 points.
Huge possession right now.
The assist from number 11, Drew Holiday.
Anderson on the drive. It's blocked. The Magic bringing it up on offense. Pass intercepted by Anderson. He puts it up. Able to put it in.
The Wolves are shooting 40% from the field.
The assist from number 42, Alexi Ajinsa.
And now he moves around the defender. He got a piece of it. Trying to keep the ball in bounds. Puts it in.
MC Conbexter. 4-2. The assist from number 11, Drew Holiday. 1 minute remaining in the fourth quarter.
Shot they want you to take. You got to get the shot you want to get at this point in the game.
No choice there. They had to stop the clock and they get the foul.
This is an enviable position they're in right now. Up 3, well under a minute left. All they need is one free throw to make it a 2-possession game. Obviously would love to extend it to a 5-point lead.
He missed 2 pressure free throws. They maintain, though, their 3-point lead.
a loose ball.
No, he loses it. Great defense. Huge time for a steal. Get him for the foul. They had to do it and stop the clock.
When you're up three with around 30 seconds to go, you need to make at least one of these two free throws to make it a two-possession game.
He converts on both at the line. It's a five-point game. He throws it from deep. Move to get inside from three-point land. And there's the foul. They had to stop that clock.
To number 33, Ryan Anderson. That's his second personal foul. Team foul.
Oops, missed the first one. Misfires on both of the line, although they still have a five-point lead.